Hello friends, so in this session we will look on the activation function and the max pooling or average pooling, so how it works. So let's proceed with it. So in our previous slide we have studied about how the feature max would be created based on the number of a filter we are using it, right? So when this important feature would be created, this would be an output after passing it to the convolutional layer, right? So now when the input size would be converted into the output image which is having important features, so the calculation, if you see the pixel size, there are some pixels which is having a negative value. So this whole output layer, this layer the which has been passed through the convolutional layer, would be passed through the activation function. And this activation function, really what it does, whatever value is less than zero, it will convert it into the zero. You remember in a ReLU activation function, if the value is less than zero, then it would be zero. And if the value is greater than zero, then it would remain the same value, right? So the 32 would remain 32, 4 would be 4, and then minus 1 would be converted into the zero. The zero would remain zero, and this minus 4 would be zero, right? So what it signifies? It signifies that the pixel having a high value is an important feature, and the pixel having a less value is having a less important features, right? So the important features are characterized by having the highest value. So that's the reason when we'll pass from the convolutional layer, we need to use the activation function as a ReLU, which will normalize your output layer and convert all the non-negative value into the zero value, right? So now what is pooling? So once we'll pass our output layer into from the activation function, this would be the matrix. Now from here, there are two types of a pooling. One is a max pooling and another is an average pooling. So what max pooling does it in this also, we need to define the size of a pooling. So here, if we have this particular matrix, so we'll define the pooling size of 2x2 matrix. So we'll go this 2x2 and check out what are the maximum or important feature in this particular pixel. Right, so if I show it over here, so over here the pooling size we have defined as 2x2, right? So it first check this particular matrix and check out what are the important features, what are the maximum important features. So if in this particular range we'll see the 9 is a maximum value of this matrix, this means this pixel is an important feature. So we extract this and keep it over here. Now again, it again check the next another 2 pixels, 2x2 pixels, and check it out which is the important features which is having a maximum value. Over here, this 8 is a maximum value, so it keep it over here. Subsequently, it will do it for this 2x2. Because we have kept the size of 2x2, and it checks the important features from this. Over here, 7, and same for this particular pixel. If we have kept this 3x3 rather than 2x2, then it will check the important features from. I'll just rub it and then again. Oops. So. Okay. So if we'll keep the pooling size 3x3, what it does it is checks the important features from this particular range of this matrix and check what is the maximum feature. So the maximum feature of this would be 3. So this is also a hypertonic parameters which needs to be checked at a time of tuning the your convolutional layer, right? So if you'll keep this pooling size very large, then this important feature, small important feature, would be lost. So it is always recommended that you can keep at least 2x2 or 3x3. If the image is very large, then you can keep 3x3, and if the image is very small, then you can keep 2x2, so that you will not lose the important feature of the pixel, right? And this is a maximum pooling. What average pooling does it? It takes the average of this. So the average of this particular range would be 3.7, and another this particular range would be 4.75. Okay, and then similarly for another two set of a pixels. So that is how we will use the maximum pooling and average pooling. So average pooling would determine that, okay, this important features of this four matrix would be 3.5, right? So sometime when we use the maximum pooling, we'll exactly find out what is an important features, and over here we'll take an average and get some blurred image. Okay, this 3.5, the average size of this particular pixel would be having a certain important features, right? So if you'll see in this particular block, you can find it out that a maximum features would be having in this particular range, because this is a maximum value, 4.75, right, which comes over here. So when you have a large text, or if you are having large videos or a high dimensional image, then it would always be recommended that you use the maximum pooling, because it takes the maximum feature rather than averaging it out. But if you are having a text image, or if you just wanted to find out the average, okay, if an ear and the whole ear would be carrying a 3x3 matrix, so you need not to check all the pixels of an ear, so you can average it out and find out, okay, this 3x3 matrix would be having features of an ears, right? So in that scenario, you can take the average pooling. So by taking an average pooling, we again reduce the size of 28 by 28 into 14 by 14, right? And if we'll do the pooling of this particular image, again, it would be reduced by 2, because the maximum pooling size by 2 by 2. If it would be 3 by 3, then it would be reduced by 3 times. So this is what we have covered in over this session. In the next session, we'll see the another important features, that are how do we concatenate all the layer, convolution layer, this pooling layer, and then pass it to the fully connected layer, and then generate an output. So thank you guys. I hope this session would be helpful for you guys. Thanks a lot.